Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Sundays with Sully. As always, I'm your host Chris Sullivan, and today we're in the Navtronics showroom again, and we're going to be going over Lumishore Lux lighting, in particular, how to install it into your MFD. So, I'm sure you're already asking yourself, what exactly does that mean? What's Lumishore? What's Lux lighting? What's an MFD? Well, let's break it all down for you real quick. MFD, multifunction display. I'm sure you already know what that is. In this case, we're going to be using the Garmin 8600 series. We're going to network that in from one of these network ports right here, standard Ethernet port from Garmin. We're going to network in our Lumishore Lumalink Command Center. That is the heart of the operation for Lumishore lighting. So, now, what exactly is Lux lighting? Lux lighting is a fully color-tunable LED light for above water on your boat. In this case, we have full RGB, but we also have fully white color tunability. I'm sure everybody out there has seen the bright white of the LEDs. We've also seen the warm whites. This allows us now to run the full spectrum of color for RGB, red, green, and blue, as well as the whites. We go all the way from warm white to a cool white. We now are able to control that. In this case, in this application, we're going to be controlling it from our Garmin MFD. You can also control it on the Lumishore remote control. It's a little 4-inch display, mounts onto wherever you want on your helm. You can put it on there. We can also control it from an app on our phone. So if you're not at the helm and you want to change colors, you can go ahead and do it that way as well. So how do we install all this? Why do we want to install all this? And what all is this going to take? On Lumishore Lux lighting, we're going to do a courtesy light, and we're also going to do a Lux down light. Again, both of them color tunable, and you're going to see a color difference between the down light, which is more for your cabin spaces, and your courtesy light, which is generally down at your feet, kind of lighting walkways, trying not to blind people if you're moving around the boat at night, but it kind of helps set a nice scene. As we mentioned, Lumishore Lumalink Command Center. This is the heart of the operation. This has an Ethernet port that's going to come out. In this case, because we are using a Garmin device, we need to use a Garmin data cable here. We're going to use the Garmin crossover cable from Lumishore right here. Just plugs right in. We put it into the Lumishore link right here. And now we're going to come out. We come down. We go right into our Garmin display. Ties right in. As soon as this is plugged in and powered up, it's good to go. It's ready. And there's nothing to do on the Garmin side. It sees it and says, oh, hey, I got a Lumishore hooked up. Great, let's roll with it. So, coming off of the Lumishore, we have our power wire coming down. We have our network wires coming out. In this case, we have done, like I said, the Lux down lighting, but we're also using the Lux strip lighting. Everybody's really familiar anymore with the LED strip lights. This case, they do standard strip lighting, and they also do you're gonna see a lot of this moving forward, the LED neon lighting. It's a much smoother light. It literally looks like neon, but it's a flexible light. You're gonna see a lot more of that in the future. So this has the ability to drive two different zones with the strip lighting, whereas with our Lux downlight controller, this is one zone. You can put up to 10 lights on it, daisy chain together. You take the data wire in, data wire out, and you just daisy chain them all in. Everybody comes together, but it's only a single zone. So if you want to have multiple colors on your boat, you want the cabins in red, you want the salon in blue, you want the cockpit in white, you're going to need three of these guys. But that's it. You plug these in, you've got your power goes out to each one of these. You've got a data cable that comes out from here. It's going to go into this one. And then from this one, we're going to go up and we come into this one. At the very end, whatever the last one's going to be, you're going to want to put a terminating resistor in, which they include. You're going to go ahead, you're going to plug that in. Now we've stopped it. We've now completed a mini network here for the Lumishore. That's all that's required for it. And then you go ahead, you wire your lights in. In our case, up here, we've wired in, like I said, the three lights. We've got two down lights and we've got our strip light going across. And once I turn this all around, you're going to see how we control those from the Garmin devices. One last little thing I'd like to go over while we have the backside here is from the Lumalink Command Center, we have the ability to tie in to the stereo. Because this is our showroom display, I like to showcase everything that we can possibly do with our devices. So in this case, it's a standard headphone jack. We've taken it to an RCA splitter. We've run that RCA cable down. and that comes over to our Fusion Apollo head unit. In this case, we're running it on zone 4 because on this stereo install, we didn't use zone 4. It was a dead zone. Didn't use it. Didn't need it. So now I can control the intensity of the lighting from the stereo when we have it on the music side of things. So that's a really nice way to be able to handle that and set those things up. So I'm going to go ahead, speed this whole process up, and turn all this around, plug things in, and you're going to see what exactly this looks like from the other side when you have this on your boat and plugged into your MFD. So here we go. Okay, so we got it all turned around. Now, as soon as you plug in everything, everything's powered up, you know you've done it right when you see the Lumishore Luma Link icon show up on your MFD. Garmin World, that's going to be under the One Helm app on the Raymarine screens of your Axiom, Axiom Pros, and XLs. You might have to swipe left or right to see it. Simrad should just show up. And again, you might have to scroll up and down to find it, but it is there if it is wired up properly. There's actually LED lights on the backside of each one of those devices that blink blue. Kind of tells you what's going on. If it's blinking blue, if it's not blinking, you can say, hey, I've got power, but no data, or I'm not talking. So it's all covered in the instructions. Really easy. You can figure all that out. It's self-explanatory. So once we do have the LumaLink up and running, we come in here, we go to Lumishore, we select LumaLink, we're going to the screen. It's going to pause. It has to go back through, do the handshake with it. It's going to come up. In this case, we've already set it up for the two zones. We know that we have Luma Lux lighting in the overhead. In this case, we've got our Lux down light, and we also have our courtesy light. Courtesy light's not as bright, it's kind of meant to be down at your feet, give a nice accent lighting without blinding you. This is your standard overhead 3-inch hole, cut it in, spring-loaded light. It's got three wires. You've got a power, a ground, and a data wire. Everything daisy chains together, really easy to use. Low power draw again because it's LED. So pretty easy to use. So now we can come into here, we can go into all zones. We want to turn on all zones, and we come over and we say all zones, we want to turn it up. Here's our color wheel. Now, pretty standard, we can come across the board. You'll notice that the lights above over here for this, as well as down here, we go red, we can say blue, we can say green, we can do all that. That's nifty, that's great. Everybody's been able to do that for a while. What sets the Lumishore lights apart are the color tunability. When I say color tunability, you get your standard RGB, but we also have a white color wheel on this side, and that's going to take us from our cool whites, which are kind of the blue whites, a little bit brighter, and it's going to allow us to go all the way over to the warm whites, kind of a softer glow inside. If you want to kind of set an atmosphere mood on your boat, in the salon, you're at anchor for the evening or whatever, you can set that up. And again, come in here, and it's just this easy to go through. And you cycle through everything and you say, you know what? I want warm white. Great. There you go. Hey, I want bright white. There you go. Hey, I want to turn it down. Grab it. Turn it down. It's all that easy. Now, as I said before, we're installing all this onto our Garmin MFD because it's our showroom display. We want to showcase what we can do. But you can also do a 4-inch display strip from Lumishore. Gives you the controllability of the lights. It's all button actuated. Very easy to use. And you can also use your phone and the app, download it, control it, so you can be sitting down below and change the colors, do whatever you want. So, nifty, great, we can change colors, we have different zones. Up in the left-hand corner, we've got zones, brings us back, we've got our Lux lighting and our strip lighting. As I said, we've set up two separate zones on this one. So we come into our strip lighting, we're gonna turn that off, we can turn off our Lux lighting. If we just wanna have strip lighting, we can turn on just strip lighting. Want just Lux lighting, we can turn it on, turn it off. Now, we come in here, we turn them on, that's great. But let's go into Lux light. And now, as soon as I touch on that, we're gonna get this bottom screen is gonna come up and we're gonna be able to set things for strobe, for music, for RGB, for scenes, for all of that. So, we come in here, we say, you know what? Yeah, that was cool, we did green. We did green, that's nifty. We can come over here and we can say, hey, do I want to change or adjust or tune any of these colors because I don't like how they're looking? You can do that right here. You want to come in here when we want to say, hey, there's a preset scenes, I guess, modes, if you will. We do RGB, full color spectrum, obviously, right, without the white. We do ice blue, that's going to go from our cool white to our blues, and it's just going to cycle through. We've got Miami, which is kind of our purples into our blues and our aquas. We've also got sunset. These are presets already in there, already available, and we can decide, do we want them bright or not? We can also come in here and we can say, hey, you know what? I want this to go faster. So we come in, we speed it up. Now it's going to go through the cycle and change through all of those colors just that much quicker. So you can have that and just say, you know what? That's what I want in my cockpit. I want to have this nice zone set up for this. And then you can come back out and say, you know what? But down below, I just want some red light. I don't want it to be too blinding. We come in here, we say red. Great. This is red up here. This is just going through its light show down here. Now, if you like that, you can save that right here under this gear icon. You can come in and say, hey, you know what? I really like this. We go scenes and we say create a scene. And now we can come in and we can tell it from here. Which ones do we want? Do we want to save it as this, which is what we've got right now? We can say, hey, that's a new scene. But in this case, we're just going to back out of here on this little keyboard. And we're going to call it show for the sake of this. You say enter. And now we tell it to save. Now, show is saved right here. It's good to go. We come in here, we go to show. It's going to go through and do that every time for us. It's preset. It's a one and done. And it's just that quick to set a scene. It's really easy. In our case, I did a full RGB, which means both of these lights are all going to cycle through. This one's going to go. I set this one up to go a little faster than this one, just so there's some differential, kind of create something for your eyes to see a visual effect. You also have the ability to do a strobe effect, if that's something you desire. I know some of the fishing guys like doing it for the underwater lights or whatever, so you can do that. Want a party mode, you can do that. If you want to have this be blue and you want to have another zone be strobe, you can do that. So that's everything that's going on there. One of the other things that you can do with this is we can come over here and we can go to the music. Now, as I mentioned before, this has an audio input. In our case, I took the audio input from zone 4 of my Fusion Apollo stereo here, and I said, you know what, I'm going to key that in. So now I can come into here, I can just turn this up. Now the lights are going to go to the beat. When I come into the zones, we'll see that I can set up how much do I want, how bright do I want it. Giving up and giving in, tell me, in this house of mine. Nothing ever comes down. I want the background to be with the stars light. Great, there we go. Step in, will it save us from the same willy? Cause this house is strip lighting, same thing. I want some white lighting on there. Boom. So just that easy. So that's it. That's Lumishore Lux lighting in a nutshell. So hopefully you learned a little something. Maybe you got some ideas for your boat for winter projects. Maybe you're down south and you need something to really set your boat apart at the sandbar. Hey, look into this Lux lighting. Tie it into your stereo. Get a whole show going on. You know? So that's it. That's all I got for you guys today. Be sure to give us a follow on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook at Navtronics. And if you have any questions for us, feel free to drop us a line. And who knows? Maybe I'll select it to be answered on the next Sundays with Sully. Until then, I'm going to keep jamming out my tunes over here.